The kind of stuff that I'm drawn to and enjoy are kind of one-off pieces which are slightly unique, slightly off the wall, a bit out there.
He collects all manner of stuff. There's no real rhyme or reason to what he collects. A weird mix of stuff. But he might have something.
We've got a lot of stuff, and it's just time to get rid of some now and make some space. Otherwise, we're going to end up like sort of hoarders, and that can't happen.
So you've got a lot of stuff lying around.
We might as well start here, if you like.
Yeah, sure.
Have a look.
Have a look. Oh, my God, look at that.
Weren't expecting that, were you?
No. I love the fact that he's built a time machine in his shed. Don't really need to say any more. He built a time machine in his shed. So is it a copy of the one off the time time machine?
Yes, it is. Yeah, the H.G. Wells one.
Does it work?
We haven't tested it out yet.
Tested it out.
Yeah,
okay.
We've got to do a bit more wiring and then.
All right. Okay.
Where are we going to go first?
This is properly mad. It really is. What possessed you to make this then?
I remember the film from when I was a kid, and I said those fatal words. I think we could build that.
What a top dad. He's built a time machine for his little boy in his shed.
I make a lot of the stuff. I suppose some of it's nostalgia from my point of view, and it's just great for him because he's out there with me and he's building stuff and getting involved in it all, and it's better than him sitting in front of the television.
Well, fantastic. Well, clearly you're a man after my own heart, so I'd like to have a look around what you've got for sale and just have a poke about. But that's really, you can't really top that, can you?
I don't know.
You're going to have to try hard.
Yeah. Anything in the boxes I need to know about? I don't want to go opening all the boxes. Anything in there?
To be honest, probably the only thing, unless you want a mummified cat, the only other thing in here is probably is this safe.
A mummified
that you might
cat?
Like.
Oh my good God.
Good grief.
It is, it's like a little satanic, devil-y looking thing. Look at his teeth.
I've had that since I was 12. My auntie gave me that.
It's great. I like that.
Unbelievably, there is a market for mummified cats. In medieval times, it was considered good luck to seal a live cat in the walls of new homes. They are sometimes uncovered during restorations and can sell for up to £2,000.
I like
it. You're not going to get it, pal.
But Drew decides against the cat and goes from something macabre to something gothic.
What's that there?
They're
lights.
Light cages, yeah.
Are these for sale, Jeremy?
Yeah, they can be.
They could be, yeah?
Yeah.
They're very well made. I don't think they're very old. They're probably only 20 or 30 years old, if that. They're a great decorative pair of wall-mounted torchairs. Put a big pair of candles in there. They're just a cool-looking thing. Put your candles in, stick them outside. Look pretty.
Late 20th century decorative wall torchairs like these are popular with props companies and interior designers and could sell for almost £300 the pair.
I think £60 is about right.
That sounds fair.
I think if they were older, they'd be worth an awful lot more. They would be worth an awful lot more money, but they're not. But they've got something about them. We've got a sort of Gaudi-esque bit to the top there. And, yeah, so £60
that's
for the
good.
Pair.
That's fair enough.
Is that all right?
That's good.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. Okay, great stuff. So you got some stained glass windows?
Oh, yeah,
leaded windows?
Had those. Rather. Well, we were going to put them in our new extension, but we opted for something else in the end.
They're quite pretty, aren't they? I like these because they're in a cast iron frame. Second half of the 19th century, those are going to be. But these are something you'd want to get rid of?
Yeah, for sure, yeah, because, I mean, I'd have to build a summer house now just to put those in.
Once restored, Victorian stained glass windows like these can fetch around £220 for a pair.
What do you want to do for these?
60 quid.
For the pair?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, OK, right. We'll have those. Yeah. They've got that sort of lancet effect to the top there. They're very pretty. They've both got moulded glass roundels. We'll give them a polish. They'll look $1 million. OK, lead on. More sheds.
OK, shed round the corner here.
OK, looks good already. So what have you got in there? Oh, my good God.
Yeah,
Your kids must be traumatised.
He's been brought up on it, so he's quite used to it, but...
And you're married.
Yes. Yeah. Funny, isn't it?
He's the classic British... eccentric, and there's just not enough of them around. Green Goblin.
Green Goblin helmet.
What, for people?
Yeah, care, the padding's not in there, so be careful.
Oh,
actually, if I press this button...
It hurts, actually. Oh, my good God.
Sorry, was it?
You're really out there, aren't you? The only other thing was that you've got this fruit picker ladder behind you.
Yeah, I've got another one just up there, it's a bit shorter.
Agricultural antiques like these fruit pickers' ladders are very rare. After restoration, Drew could sell these for around £220.
OK, so what do you want to do? Are they for sale?
Yeah, something you'd sell? Sell, yeah. £20 each.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. They're good decorative pieces, aren't they? I'm really glad I called in. I didn't think we'd get anything. And he's got loads of stuff in the house he wants to show me now as well, so I want to get in there.
Not only are the prices great, but Jeremy's taste coincides perfectly with Drew's.
What a great-looking place.
Thank you.
They're ahead of the game in so many respects with what they're doing, whether they realise it or not. Their whole look and their combination of their antiques put together in modern settings, in modern ways, it's brilliant. Really, just, and it's natural. They've just done it because that's what they like. To see one that's just evolved like that, because he just likes 1950s-inspired sci-fi, and he likes skeletons, and he likes antlers, and he likes period-old furniture. This chair, is this something you'd sell?
Yeah, no, that's something we'd get rid of. We've had it probably 12 years.
It's just a great shape.
Is it a club chair,
club
isn't
chair,
it?
Club chair, yeah. Ow, oh, my knee. OK. It's had a lot done to it. Half the frame's new.
Well-worn leather club chairs like these are always popular with designers and photographers. Drew knows that even if he does nothing to this chair, it will sell for around £220.
Being a bit mean at 100.
That's kind of the figure I had in my head. So.
Yeah, it's just a great shape, good size, very commercial thing, something I can sell pretty easily. Trendy at the moment in any condition. Oh, I love that Rocket Man helmet. Do you wear it around the house when there's nobody, when there's nobody else in?
Only on Sundays.
He was telling me that that was the one that the guy wore at the Rocketeer premiere. The guy, the star, put it on and walked around with it. There was only 1,000 made of them.
There you go. It's like a club.
What do you reckon? On my Vespa?
It's you, mate. It's you. It's absolutely you. It really is.
That's good.
And you've got a Batman suit as well.
Yes.
Yeah, you just never cease to amaze me. I didn't see that before. So you got a time machine and a Batman suit.
I made the majority of it. The cow came from America, and it's all wearable. Halloween.
Do you wear it?
I did last Halloween, yeah.
Halloween's a big thing in your life, isn't it?
You can try that one as well if you want to.
No, you're all right. I'll leave the rubber suit to you.